One of our favorite places here in North Central Florida is the Florida Museum of Natural History, and that's why we're here, aren't we, Darcie?
Exactly.
There's a lot of things happening here. Let's talk about the lobby, first of all.
Our new lobby look says natural history, and it's also a lot more comfortable for people to just come and hang out with us.
Yeah, and the video wall. And Elvis looks like he's a little more lit up in different ways.
The mammoth looks great.
He demanded
it.
But the big deal right now, the megalodon, the largest shark that ever lived. I have this in my pocket. What is this, Darcie?
Well, you happen to have a very large adult megalodon tooth.
A real tooth.
Beautiful fossil. Tells us a lot about the extinct largest shark that ever lived, mm-hmm. which lived 17 to 2 million years ago. Mm-hmm. But also studying megalodon tells us a lot about sharks today.
How long was a megalodon?
We think it was about 60 feet long. And we know that from studying things like the width and length of shark tooth and comparing that to great white sharks
right.
today.
And I love that mock-up you have here. It just kind of gives you an idea of how big this shark really, really was. And Florida used to be underwater, so literally megalodon used to be swimming above us, right?
That's right. And so that's why we find a lot of shark's teeth in Florida, especially after rains. You can go through the creeks and collect shark's teeth.
Sharks don't have bones, do they?
Sharks don't have bones. Mm. They have a lot of cartilage. The tooth is usually the only thing that survives, but backbones, centra, that do gradually become more bony, and those sometimes fossilize. And so we have some centra in the exhibit that you can count the growth rings to tell how old the shark was when it died.
We get an idea of how much food it ate.
Megalodon, you know, ate pretty much whatever it wanted
whatever
to.
It
probably ate whales. There's some evidence of that.
That's good to know. Somebody eats more than I do. Yeah. And I like behind us, now don't look, it's scary, the different jaws you have behind us.
They're all megalodon, a 30-foot shark to a 60-foot shark. So you can get an idea of the size from just the jaw alone.
You have the Sharkabet even.
The entire alphabet made up with paintings by Ray Troll of different kinds of sharks through time.
Florida Museum of Natural History is involved with some great research going on.
The Panama Canal is being widened, and our paleontologists have been down there researching the fossils, including a bunch of small megalodon teeth that turn out to be from baby megalodons.
Goodness.
And are evidence that sharks, even back when megalodon lived, were using shallow marine environments for nurseries for their young.
So many other exciting exhibits.
Our butterfly rainforest.
Fabulous.
The underwater larger-than-life fish.
One of my favorites.
The cave. The fossil hall.
Bring yourself, the family, anyone you know, the Florida Museum of Natural History. What are your hours?
Monday through Saturday, 10 to 5. Mm-hmm. Sunday, 1 to 5. Mm-hmm. And you can visit us on Facebook.
Come to the Florida Museum of Natural History, right?
Right.
Boy, it would have been hard to brush that tooth, wouldn't it?